Why would she say that? That's crazy. Mom BG, you gotta see this.
What's up?
I gotta show you something on the screen. It's pretty crazy.
You won't believe what these girls are saying on Facebook today. So, this one chick, and the funny thing about it is, she is white. So she doesn't know really that much about black people hair. But she done told the black girl that her hair is too nappy. Now what she know about nappy hair?
Nothing.
Why has it become such a big deal about having type 1, type 2, type 3, type 4? Who cares what type of hair? Do you got hair on your head? Do it look good? Do you use something? Do you do something to your nappy head or straight hair? White people look crazy too.
Hey guys, Ms. Ricky here, and I am going to be doing a video on hair typing. And this is a video that's kind of close to my heart because for me being a black woman, hair type was very important when I grew up. You know, the better your hair was, the better off you were. The guys or the boys looked more at the girls who were light-skinned and had, you know, the long curly hair. There has been so many different people who claim that they were the ones who started the hair typing thing, okay? And I'm not going to name anybody in specific who has their own category because all of these different hair type charts measure the curl differently. So a person who might be 3C will appear on someone else's chart as 4A. And it's can be very, very confusing and all this kind of foolishness and stuff. But we're not going to go there with that. The first thing that we're going to talk about that you probably don't know is from 80 to 90% of the human population is born with curly hair. 80% of the human on the earth, people are born with curly hair or some form of wave or curl in their hair. And a lot of people straighten out their hair. That just become what's popular now for people to go and wear their hair straight. Okay, now, one interesting fact that a lot of people don't know is that people with extremely curly typed hair, their scalp produces more sebum than a person with stray hair. The only difference is that your hair, because of its curliness, prevents the oil that's produced from your scalp to go all the way down to your ends. Now I'm going to go into some of the myths that were out there about why people's hair grows curly. Okay, first myth that I heard was that one side of your hair strand, so if this was your hair strand and they're both, one side of your hair strand grows faster than the other side of your hair strand, which creates a bend in the hair and it causes your hair to grow curly. Another one is that your hair, if your hair is more round in diameter compared to oval or flat in diameter, the more flatter your hair is, the more curly your hair is. Another myth is the twisting of your hair. So as your hair grows out of your scalp, your hair will twist. But the more your hair twists as it grows out of the scalp, the more curly your hair is. That's another one. Now this one is not a myth, but it's actually a fact. And it's dealing with, you know, medications or hormone treatments that you're getting. If you're taking medication or hormone treatments, yes, it can change the curly pattern in your hair. Okay? Because it has to do a lot with the hormones and the proteins and all that good stuff that grows out of your hair. Or grows out of your scalp. Okay, the last myth, supposedly, is that at the bottom of our hair, where the bulb is, the hair shaft, if your hair shaft is straight, your hair is supposed to grow straight. Now, if your hair shaft is slightly bent or has a hook to it, then it's going to cause the hair to grow out of the shaft and then twist like that, okay? Okay, but the truth, the big kahuna of what they've come up with is the dulcified bond. Now, I had talked to you guys plenty of times before about the dulcified bond. The dulcified bond is what perms, relaxers used to break down to either add curl to your hair or to remove the curl from your hair. Okay, so the best way I can explain this to you is to give you guys a little visual. So, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Alrighty, there, right. Okay, now this is a strand of a person with straight hair. Scientists noticed that the bond in a person with straight hair, the dosified bonds are actually closer together, and the magnetic magnetic connection between all of the bonds keep the hair straight. But in a person who has curly hair, the bonds are further apart. And because they want to naturally be close together, they want to pull each other close together. And this is what causes our hair to curl. The less dosified bonds we have in our hair, apparently, the more curly hair we have. Okay, so now that we're finished with that, we are going to talk more about the differences in the types, okay? Now, people want to say that because you have type 4 hair, that your hair is thicker. Well, that doesn't necessarily mean that your hair is thicker. They say that people with straighter hair is actually more thicker than people with curly hair. But that's not always true. You can have type 1 hair and have thin hair. You can have type 3 hair and have thin hair. You can have type 4 hair and it be thin or coarse. It doesn't mean that any type has any certain specific characteristic, okay? The only characteristics that you can truly say about a person's hair is it extremely curly? Is it a medium curl? Or is your hair straight? Is your hair wavy? These are characteristics. Now, why is it important for you to know what kind of type of hair you have? Well, it's important because it tells you what products will necessarily work in your hair. Now, if you have extremely curly hair, like me, you cannot use products that are very drying. Like clarifying shampoos that strip your hair when you wash it. It's very drying. Another thing is, people with extremely curly hair, we have to moisturize our ends. So using, grease or whatever you use to moisturize your hair at the ends is a very important thing. Now, people with straighter hair, it might weigh their hair down and they don't want all that stuff. They really don't need all that stuff because, you know, their hair is, the oil from their scalp gets to their hair more easily. Now, this is the one thing I want to say. Even so, people with straight hair or more wavy or curly hair, the longer their hair gets, the more they need to moisturize their ends. So, bottom line, people need to moisturize their ends. Basically, the last thing that I just want to say is that it's not about the curl and it's not about the length necessarily. It's about the health of your hair. All right? So, I will see you guys later. I love you all. Peace and love. And don't forget to make some requests. Come on now. I'm going to run out of videos to make now. Nah, I always got stuff to say. All right, but I'll see you beautiful people later, and